Welcome everyone. I'm here with Damon Ezekiel, owner of Ezekiel Eyes. Welcome, Damon.
Hi. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity.
Great. Today we're talking about contact lenses, but especially pediatric contact lenses.
Yes.
Yep. Now, you fit contact lenses for babies, is that right?
It's crazy, but we do, yes.
Wow.
So we see babies who are born with cataracts. So, you know, if you and I had a cataract, we would get the cataract removed and an artificial lens implanted. And that would be with us for the rest of our life. These little guys, and my youngest patient's 4 weeks old, born with cataracts removed. There's two ways of doing it. They can implant a lens, but you know, the baby's eyes lengthwise is really small. So they're just guesstimating the size of a lens and also what prescription to put in. So what we like to do, and in conjunction with the ophthalmologist at the Perth Children's Hospital, they send them to me. We fit them up with a gas permeable scleral lens, which is fenestrated. It has three holes in it, and we fit them with that. And down the track, we then patch the good eye and try and get the not so good eye, which had the cataract, removed to come to the party and development, improve the development of the retina, the back of the eye. So the contact lens goes in the morning, comes out at night. Child wears it all day, and the beautiful thing about this material is it breathes so beautifully that the junior can sleep with it. So during the day, have a nap, wake up, and the optics of these is going to be so much better than a pair of glasses, because these glasses are going to be really thick, and looking straight ahead is great, but off center, trying to get a child to keep them on, a baby, is just a nightmare. So with these type of contact lenses, they're just fantastic. The hardest part is not the patient, but mum and dad, teaching mum and dad how to get the lens in and out. And it's a challenge. It's tough. It's really hard because you've got this little baby there and you're popping a lens in and out. It's scary for mum and dad.
Mm.
Once they get the technique, it's not so difficult. But I have a video which I show them of mums and dads who have actually can get the lens in and out pretty easy. And, you know, we just slowly work it through. We find sometimes that, you know, one parent might be better at getting in, one might be better at getting out. I prefer to have both mum and dad come at that initial consultation and teach how to get in and out. Cleaning, it's a rigid lens. It's very easy to clean and keep clean. And it's just really good for the patient. When junior is older, and as they get older, the beautiful thing about this lens is we can change the curve on the front of the eye. So junior's world is here, and as he or she gets bigger and their world opens up, we'll change the curve on the front of the lens. We send it back to the lab, adjust the prescription, and so it's the same lens. So we can get quite a few years out of this lens. What will happen, though, as junior grows, their eye becomes bigger, the globe, that the lens becomes too small and will become tight. So there's certain adjustments we can do to the back of the lens to try and get more out of this lens. Ideally, if we can get 18 months to 2.5, maybe 3 years out of a lens, that'd be great.
Mm-hmm.
We tend to make the lens with an extra bit of body initially, and we can do these adjustments. And then when they're older, whether it's, you know, 6, 8, 10, in conjunction with the ophthalmologist, we have that discussion, and then they might implant a lens.
Right.
I do have a couple of patients who are now about 13, 14, and they're doing really well. They've upgraded from the scleral lens to a corneal lens. Their vision is stable, and there's no need, you know, from mum and dad's point of view and from the child's point of view, there's no need to go down the path of having surgery and having an implant lens. They're doing well with the corneal lens. Their vision's great. So let's delay another operation. So, you know, it's a fantastic journey. It's a tough gig, though, to be born with, a cataract, whether it's one eye or both eyes.
Mm.
But, you know, it is what it is. And to give this child the best potential vision for them as they get older, glasses is an option. But really, you know, the image on the retina is going to be so much better with a contact lens. And for us, we prefer fitting with a rigid lens because of the health benefits of a rigid lens, and the visual quality is just going to be so much better.
For sure. It's getting the best for the child.
Absolutely. Yeah. So long term, that's our result.
Yeah.
We're after.
And for parents, is there a particular time when of day when they find it's easier to put a lens in or out?
Yeah, Lee, that is a really good question. So the easiest thing to do is if juniors had a feed and got a full tummy,
yep,
they're nice and sedate, and that's the best time to either put the lens in or take it out.
Right.
And, you know, I try and encourage my parents to, let's work on that routine. Kids love routine.
Yeah.
So whether in the morning it's a feed and then lens in, and at night it might be a feed or bath, books, whatever, and then the lens out. And the younger they are, the easier it is.
Right.
The older they are, you know, when they're 2 and 4 and things like that, and they can start throwing their weight around, then you have to negotiate. It's a lot harder. If they grow up knowing this is what is normal for me,
yep,
then it's so much easier.
That's good. They're into the routine of it.
Yeah, exactly. And they want their lens in so they can see and get on with their world and their day.
Yeah, that's great. So it's, and for these kids, although having a cataract isn't a good thing, you're really helping them to have a kickstart and get into life.
Absolutely, yeah. And if we don't do it now while the development of their retina is taking place and their visual system, if we don't do it now, it's just not going to happen. So it's pretty amazing that you can make such a difference to someone who's, you know, this big.
Yeah.
So when you see them, then they're this big, and, you know, you can make an impact. You can get them to where they really want to be.
And you've been practicing for many years now, and you've seen many kids grow up.
And they've, you know, some have had implant lenses and they still come in because they'll need reading glasses, or they might need a little bit of a top up for their distance. But it's amazing, really, you know, from 29 years of practice to see them. I've got one girl who's at doing a music degree. And she's amazing, and she's, you know, she's had her implants. She's a bilateral, so both eyes, born with cataracts, and just amazing, you know. Normal life drives doing a university degree, majoring in music. Just, it's amazing. It's amazing the impact you can have on people's lives, you know, where you just think, oh, I'm just doing my stock standard job.
Yeah.
But to them, it's more, because you're giving them an opportunity, you know. You're allowing them to drive, you're allowing them to hold down a job and do what's you and I take for granted. It's pretty special.
Absolutely. And that quality of life is fantastic.
I guess I don't realize some of the stuff we do is until you stand back and realize what you can enable people to do.
Yeah,
when you just think, I'm just doing what I normally do all day every day, but it's pretty special.
Absolutely.
It's great.
Fantastic. Well, thanks everyone for watching and hearing about how Damon fits young kids with contact lenses, and it's an amazing ability.
Thanks, Lee.
Damon, what's the best way to go ahead and make an appointment to see?
So, Lee, you can either go through our website, or at ezekieleyes.com, or you can give us a buzz on 9386 3620, or there'll be some links at the bottom of this video.
Fantastic.
So thank you for your time.
Thank you, Damon. And please give this video a like as well and share it with your friends. That'd be great. Thanks, everyone, for watching.